I can help Dana and check out Victoria's room to find out if she is the kind of person I hope she's not.
Alright, so we're back with some more Life is Strange. And at the moment, I am trying to figure out still what we're supposed to be doing here. So
leave me alone, Victoria, Max. Again. Get a clue.
Nope, that was no use at all. So we're supposed to go find...
No need to go there now.
Okay, how are we supposed to do this? This is really, really kind of confusing.
Welcome to Black Hill.
Max, Dana, Stella, Juliet. I think there was something mentioned about Victoria in the last one. So let's go back over towards our room and we'll go across the hall. So if this is Max's room, this is Victoria's room then. Let's see what Victoria says. Ooh, it's a nice little room too.
She's actually got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. I hate you, Victoria.
Let's use her computer.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
So, it says, Taylor, so sad to inform you that I totally punked Juliet and Dana just now. All I had to do was mention that Juliet saw nasty sex from Dana on Zach's phone. Dumbass, believe me, and I expect to be a dorm rampage going on soon. Juliet deserves this for slutting Zach away from me. As for Dana, who gives a shit? Get out your popcorn, XXVC. So, that is all that we need to do. And now, let's go chase down the one girl over here. I forget her name now, suddenly. Print email. That's what we have to do. Okay. So now, we'll take the...
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
And we'll leave the room. Alright. So now, we're gonna go show this to Juliet here, and maybe she'll believe us.
Juliet, read this.
Of course! I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max.
Well then.
You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
And that's all we needed. Took like 10 minutes already just to freaking get the flash
Almost
drive.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Oh god. Yeah, let's just take this really
Must quick. Protect my precious, so Max never has to chase it down again.
Alright.
That looks like a home pregnancy test.
Oh god. Let's just see what this says here really quick.
Max? That's mine! Thank you!
Oh.
You're not helpful!
Anything
You're
about,
just nosy!
Zachary,
I think you better go.
You know, anything you want to mention? No,
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again.
Oh shit, okay, let's just go back.
But I could rewind and make it up to her.
Yeah, we never picked up that test. Well, I'll be going now.
Hey, Dana. Just...
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Dana, I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
My phone just went off. Of course.
Of course.
I was pregnant. Was.
Oh. What about the other?
Deadbeat Dad? You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday. And it's not Zachary.
Sorry to pry. It's not my business. And I won't be at the game Friday. Not much school spirit, I guess.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
Well, let's just leave her alone. And looks like Warren said something. I hope so. Okay, so I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can get on all the cars. The more I text, the longer I take on my way. Okay, bye. So, let's close out of that, and let's head back over to the parking lot. This game is actually pretty well done.
Fuck this shit!
Wait, ow, is this Warren? No, it's Zachary. Okay,
damn.
Speak.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
I could almost feel sorry for him if he wasn't such a serious dick. Poor Juliet.
Well then. Victoria said something. By the way, thanks, but we're not friends. Well then. Fuck you too then. There are some annoying dogs going on. Alright, there we go. I closed my window because my neighbor's dogs were going off, and I don't know if they were even going to do anything about it, so...
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying? What?
No, and leave me alone.
Take a photo. In case something gets serious here.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront, so you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone.
I wonder what that was about.
Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
Man, I should have stepped in between Kate and David. That asshole was so over the line.
Fuck something up and then...
I could rewind and try something different.
Alright, let's do this again. And this time, we'll intervene.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Well then.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping
me. I swear, the character Max, the main character that we've been playing as, actually seems like somebody else I know. Like, I've been pointing out, you know, there's some people here in this, or characters in this game, that honestly look like somebody that I've seen before, or somebody I know, and it's kind of strange, I guess. I don't really know. Anyways, I guess we're supposed to go over here.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Yo, Max, check it out.
Here's your flash.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Ooh. This could be a photo.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Nope.
No, I've been way too busy with class. And life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, drama queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now. Answer me,
bitch! I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No! You told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
Well, we're in trouble
and did
now.
What? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
He actually looks
Do not
crazy.
Analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
I could call the police.
Do it! The Prescotts own the pigs here.
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
Wait,
in the bathroom!
No.
Well then. And that's
Max?
The girl.
Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren.
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
There's no way I can walk to the town from here.
So we just completely left behind Warren.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt, and you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Who's Mark Jefferson?
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the
90s. Oh, I guess that's the teacher.
I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
So don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Give me a break. I was going through changes. Like you.
I guess those changes included dumping me from your life.
That's not true, Chloe.
Bullshit. You thought you hook up with all these art pricks in Seattle. Didn't happen, though.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max. Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Alright, so I guess now we've learned that Max and Chloe are pretty good friends, or at least they were, and then, you know, stuff happened, I guess. But let's see what we have going on now.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Alright.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Alright. Where do we put on the music? Oh wait, there it is.
It won't play without any power.
How do we turn it on? Power strip, here we go, switch on. Alright.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Where's all her music? Why do we have to do so much work for this? What's this?
This postcard is from Rachel Ember. We had such a blast drawing these together.
Where is all her music? I have no idea. This is bugging me. Search here, I guess.
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Where is all her music? Can we ask her? Where's your music?
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I don't feel grown-up, just more confused as I get older. Especially after today.
Gee, thanks. I was hoping to hear something positive.
About me?
No, about me. Duh. I thought you'd at least be happy taking photos. Forget it.
Chart.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Well then. Let's look at this really quick and then
damn,
we'll go back and...
Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago. Ooh. She used to be a great student. When she cared.
Let's just go and put that back. That never happened. So, where's all her music?
Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
Is this her music? Nope, pictures.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Alright. Where is your music?
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room.
Search these drawers? No. Let's check the laptop.
She looks super happy.
Well, I can't figure out how to,
Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Hey, Chloe. Wait, is it in here? Is this where she keeps her music? If she told me... Yep, there we go. God, if she had told me the first time, that would have been nice, but... Whatever.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
So, Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Yep, let's go put on the music. Took forever just to find the stupid disc, but alright. Wait, no, that means that now I have more stuff to talk over, otherwise probably have a copyright issue again, so la da 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 da. So she's a pothead.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Alright, so let's go.
Are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome.
The music.
I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Alright, let's go down to the garage and get out of the room before we get a copyright strike, so... And here we are. Let's see, downstairs. Oh wait, and there's still music playing too. That's wonderful. Music stop. Music stop. What are you doing, music?
Nope. Someone locked it from the other side.
Where's the garage then? How do we get to the garage? And what is this? Absolutely, I'll be free after talk to you later. Thanks again, Max, for helping me. No problem. That guy is
an asshole. Seen this place in 5 years. All right. I should be able to find the tools I need here.
So, let's search. What is
there
here?
These are way too big. I need tiny tools.
Tiny tools. Okay. Where are some tiny tools? Are we going to have to search for 5 minutes again? Or is it going to be here somewhere? I guess not. Come on. Up here? Nope, that's
Shit.
Not tools.
Butterfingers!
Okay, let's just undo that. That never happened. And you go back up there. End of story. What is that?
kidding. This is so lame.
I have no idea where these tools are. Oh, drawer. Duh.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell.
Hold on.
He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? Chloe's stepdad is a veteran and a security guard?
Nope.
He must really hate her.
Where are... Whoa, what? Gun cabinet, that's nice. Target. Anything in here? No, we can't even check those. What about this cupboard? TV. Finding the TV will have consequences?
What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For real? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Alright. Come on, just stop. Let's see. We just need freaking tools. Are they over by this? Oh, nope, not that. That's definitely not any tools. Food. What's this?
Cool, now it's opened.
Ah, wonderful. Alright. There's still no tools. At least nothing that we can use. This is gonna bug the crap out of me now. Loop. Plank. Nope. What is this? That's nice. Ooh, map. No, I want to look at the map.
Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy.
Cool.
I wonder why.
That's where he wants to put all the cameras. Because they're all at each corner. That's how cameras are often placed. Oh, there's the tools.
Ooh, precision screwdrivers.
Yeah.
Except I can't reach them.
Turn on the washing machine. That'll help. Totally. That actually will help. And now
that was
under there.
Very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Turn this back up. Why can't I just get on my hands and knees? Push. Can we slide them out using that or something?
Man, I should have done that before they fell.
Okay. So now, let's go back again. Wait, what? Back some more? There they are. Okay, so now the tools are up there. And we'll go and we'll push this under. And now, we'll turn on the washing machine, the tools will fall. Alright, there we go. Tools, go. Bloop. Right there, onto the thing. We'll turn this back off now, because that's annoying. And we will pull out the cardboard with the tools on it.
Yes! You have mad skills, Max.
Alright, now what? Where can we put this down?
I've no password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
Oh. What was that? Not David. Unlock. No. Alright, whatever. So, where can we go fix this now? On the couch? Let's sit on the couch or something. I am so confused right now.
2 hours later.
Can I sit at her desk or something? I want to fix. Okay.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
There. That's why I wanted to know. Can I sit at your desk? Yep, that's how you fix everything. You just kinda stick a screwdriver in there and wiggle it around.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see.
Seen this before.
No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat?
In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there.
Hiding in the corner.
Damn.
You're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared, too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash from Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving.
Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance. Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
Well then. Yeah, she's seriously fucking crazy. Oh god, I just realized more copyright. No, I don't want to. I don't want to get in trouble for this shit. Okay, well, that is pretty much it for this video. I've been going on for actually much longer. It'll probably be like 20 minutes or so by the time that you guys see this, but it's been 35 minutes for me.
Dude, the music's not even on!
Asshole. I'm coming up, we need to talk.
Oh, no right. Fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, right, find a place to hide now.
Let's go head back in the closet.
Chloe,
that's
I'm coming.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not right, screwing around.
I'm not a kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
Before anything happens.
I'm giving you exactly 3 seconds to open the door. Yeah, one, two, three.
Out the window.
Shit.
What's going on in here? Why is she here?
None of your business.
I don't like strangers here.
Stop freaking. She's not a stranger. This is my friend.
Great. Another one of your friends.
Wow.
One of my guns is missing.
Oh.
Did you take it?
Oh god, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait. Is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
It's not my pot. Wow. It's from Max.
Is this true?
Let's just take the blame.
Yeah, my pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble.
God.
Like this afternoon.
Such an ass.
You don't have anything smart to say now, do
get
you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
See, I was
man, that
go
did not go well for me.
At the last moment,
if I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Max, open the window and we can blow this popsicle stand.
Right there, now we can go out the window. It wasn't working earlier. Anyways, I'm pretty much done with this video. I've been going on for much longer, almost 30 minutes now. If you guys enjoyed this video though, please be sure to hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel and you want to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe. Anyways, that's pretty much it, and I'll see you all later.
Shine your hands. Oh my God. Mm, I shall have that person too. Son of a...